Good day, mate. In this video, we're gonna learn how to make radio voice in Adobe Audition. So let's get into it. What is radio voice? My description of radio voice is full-bodied, rounded, compressed, and saturated voice. So I will try to replicate that. But that is my description of radio voice. If you have any other description of the radio voice, leave your comment down below. Okay, so I will try to imitate the radio voice in Adobe Audition. But one thing that you cannot imitate or replicate in Adobe Audition is the radio voice talent. We say it deep voice or radio voice. You have to naturally born with it, okay? Not everybody can have a deep voice, especially me. My voice is kinda treble, alright? So yeah, I don't have deep voice, but I will try my best to replicate the deep voice, okay? So, la 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 la. Let's get into Adobe Audition. So, as you see here, I'm using Peace Equalizer APO as my direct processing sound. So, my voice right now is being affected by the effects that I put in my Equalizer APO. So, I will turn it down. So you can hear my raw voice, okay? I will make new waveform in Adobe Audition. Let's say it's radio voice. 4800, okay. I will turn off this preview editor first. So this is spectral frequency display, by the way. Click here, okay, or Shift D, right. So deep voice, okay? I will try to make a deep voice. Yeah, boy. Click shift space to record. Good day. Welcome back to 69.69 radio. Is it good? I will remove this first and this. So there is no clicking of the space. Good day. Welcome back to 69.69 radio. It's kind of popping. It's kind of popping. Sorry. Let's try again. Good day. Back again to 69.69 radio. All right. Good day. Back again to 69.69 radio. Okay. Now, we'll remove the clicking noise. Boom. So, this is the result. Okay. So, first of all, before we continue adding the effects, we need to clean our noise first. As you see here, this is the noise, okay? And you see in the spectral frequency display, this is the noise, okay? We need to get rid of this, okay? So, there is two methods to clean up the noise in Adobe Audition. First, the first method is the classic method, or the traditional method is by using noise reduction process. And the second method is using the denoise plugin in Adobe Audition. Okay, so I will show you guys how to remove noise first in Adobe Audition with the traditional method or the classic method. Okay, so click here, effects and noise reduction and restoration. Click noise reduction process. Alright, so I will sample the noise first. Click here. Oh, by the way, I will turn on my effects again so you can hear my voice loud and clear. Okay. By the way, if you haven't watched the video how I direct process my voice, click right here on your screen after this video. Hey, let's go. Okay, so select the noise and capture noise print. Boom. So now Adobe Audition detect the noise here, and we will try to eliminate the noise by 100% and reduce by 20 decibel. By the way, the default preset is 50% and 16 decibel. So let's try 100% and 20 decibel. So this is maybe for some people, this is too hard noise reduction, but this is still good for me, for my mic, for my setup. I guarantee you this will not produce robotic sound. Okay, my setup. Capture noise print, select entire file, boom. And apply. Bada bing, bada boom. Done. So, as you see, the noise is gone. It's pretty clean and it still has some noise in it. It doesn't clean like 100% and make you sound robotic, right?
So, let's hear it.
Good day, back again to 69.69 Radio.
So, yeah, that's my radio voice, my attempt. So, because we process the noise first, other effects that we don't apply in the effect racks doesn't bother with our file, doesn't disturb our workflow. That's why I prefer to do the noise reduction process first. Or you can do it the second way by the denoise plugin and click apply first. I will undo this first. Boom. Okay, the noise is back. So in the first effect is click noise reduction and restoration and denoise. Okay, so this is the default preset. I will show you the preview monitor here. Click here. Okay, so we get the preview. If we click Hi-Fi noise reduction, boom. Okay, it's kind of clean up the noise. But if we add more effects, this will disturb our workflow. The voice is not great. The preview voice is not great. So we have to apply the effects first. Okay, just try it if you don't trust me. Okay, let's say this is too much of noise reduction and I will use like 60% maybe. 60% is enough. Okay. And I will click apply. Boom. But as you see right now, the preview is not precisely mirrored in because that's the little bug that never left Adobe Audition. So how to get rid of it? How to fix it? Just click the preview editor here. Boom. And show it again. Okay. Now it's perfectly mirrored. And now we process our voice with EQ. Okay. EQ first, because we will gain some volume in certain frequency first. And then we compress. Okay. EQ first, compress later. So let's hear the denoise effect first.
Good day. Back again to 69.69 Radio.
So as you hear, the denoise effect is kinda reduce our voice quality. We don't want that, okay? That's why the classic method, the traditional method, is very, very preferable, very, very good. That thing that you need to know, okay? I will undo this. Okay, let's hear it. This is the raw.
Good day, back again to 69 point.
Let's process our noise again. Noise reduction, click here. Capture noise print. Select entire file and apply. Boom. Let's hear it.
Good day. Back again to 69.69 Radio.
100% quality intact. That's why the traditional method is much, much better. So, as I said before, we need to replicate the full sound, compressed sound, and saturated. Okay? Full, compressed, saturated, that's my description. Okay, we will try to create the full sound first with the EQ. Okay, in the first effect rack here, I will add EQ, filter EQ, and parotic equalizer. So we will use vocal enhancer effect to make our job easier. I know that my mic is kind of towards treble, so I don't want this have more treble again. Okay, it's treble enough. So I will decrease the gain in the high frequency. So I'm just using like 10 decibel gain, maybe enough. Okay, and because this mic is kind of not full, okay, it's kind of crispy, it's kind of dry, we need to add more bass. Okay, bass. Now I will add like 10 decibel maybe. And on the number 4, in the radio voice, we need to add the body to the voice, okay? So the voice is more full. So in the number 4, in the mid, we will increase it by 3 decibel. Okay, this is my microphone, by the way, okay? This will not apply to your microphone because every microphone have different character. Every voice, every sound have a different character. So you need to treat your voice or treat your mic differently. Okay, just a friendly reminder. So I will decrease the Q or the bandwidth here like 1. Okay, so it will have like more fuller in the mid. And I will decrease again my treble like 8. Okay, let's hear it.
Good day, back again to 69.69 Radio.
I think I need more mid frequency, so I will add more mids. Good day, back again to 69.69 Radio. Okay, I think that's good. Now I will compress the sound. As you see here, the sound is not level because we are human being, okay? We're not robot. We talk with different volume and every words, right? So we need to level it to make our sound more easy to edit, easy to process. So click here, amplitude compression, single band compressor. So we will compress our voice here. So I will choose one of the preset here to make our jobs easier, obviously. Maybe this radio leveler. Let's see. Threshold minus 12.5. This is okay. With the more gain, I will set the gain to 0 first. I think radio sound is much, much more level than this. No bueno, no bueno. I will use voice leveler preset here. 12.1. Now, we're talking. But radio voice in my head is very, very level. We need to make the compression a little bit harder. Hard compression, like 18 to 1 ratio or 20 to 1. But 20 to 1 is like limiter. Okay. Maybe 16 to 1? 16 to 1 or 18 to 1? 16 to 1. Okay. Good enough. Let's see. So this is before, as you see, it's so much spikes in here. So this is the compressed voice. Let's hear it. Good day, back again to 69.69 Radio. Now, because we compress our sound, we need to add more volume. Okay, we need to add back the volume to the broadcast safe level, which is in television and radio broadcasting is minus 3 decibel. Okay, that's what I know, by the way. Correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, now I will add amplitude and compression effect again with hard limiter here, and I will use preset minus 3 decibel. Okay, so this will boost our voice and limit the output to the minus 3 decibel. So let's hear the result here. Good day, back again to 69.69 Radio. So that's it, guys. Did you like the result? If you have any more suggestion, drop your comment down below. And if you have any question at all, drop your comment down below again. And I will see you in the next one.